Hi friends, welcome to Kiddo Kids. Okay, so I wish you all had a very nice day today. So today also I told you I'll come back with a topic, rhymes, stories, cartoons, a lot of things to do. Okay, so now all you have to do is you have to watch Kiddo Kids, then you can also, you can surely call to Kiddo Kids, you can play games, you can tell me something about today's topic, you can tell me, many things, you can tell me what happened in your school, what you're planning to do for your, vacations or your weekend, anything that you're, planning to or you're very excited about. And also if you have a birthday today, you can tell me that also. Okay, so you can see the number on the screen, you can take your phone, you can dial and you can call right now, you can play games, many things. We have a lot of games. We have GK questions, real questions, spelling game, sentence making, dictionary, tongue twister, connection game, memory game, lot of games. Okay, so today our topic, before I get into our topic, let's go for a caller. Hello.
Hello.
Hello, what's your name?
My name is Sachin.
Sachin, welcome to Kiddo Kids.
Thank you.
How are you, Sachin?
I'm fine.
How's your day today? It was good?
Yeah, it was good.
Okay, so did you, is your exams going on?
No.
No, okay. So all your exams are over?
No, my exam is starting on Thursday.
Thursday, okay. So which exam do you have first?
English?
English?
Yes.
Okay, best of luck. So then after, after all your examinations, then summer vacation.
Yeah.
So summer vacation, when does your school, when's your summer vacation beginning?
My school is closed.
When?
My school is closed.
July?
No, June 27.
June 27?
Yeah.
Okay, so must be waiting for that day, right?
Yeah.
Only 2-3 weeks left.
Yeah.
Okay. So anyway, Sachin, so what are you planning to do in your summer vacation? Going to India?
No.
Okay, staying here.
Yeah.
So what are you planning to do here?
In my school, I have summer
camp. Okay, in your school you have summer camp, so you're going for that.
Yeah.
Good. Okay, that's nice. So anyway, Sachin, so in this summer camp, so many things will be there. So you'll be, totally in that.
Yeah.
Good. Okay. So anyway, now let's, go for a game.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, which game do you want to play?
Can I play
Atlas? What do you want to play?
Atlas.
Atlas, okay, your favorite game.
Yeah.
Okay, so anyway, you start then.
Salala,
A or H? I have a doubt.
H.
H. Okay. H. Hyderabad.
Hyderabad.
D. Doha. Doha. A. Australia.
Abu Dhabi.
Abu Dhabi. I. Indonesia.
Indonesia. Ajman.
Ajman. N. Norway.
Norway. Why? Yokohama.
Yokohama. A. Agra.
Agra.
Alain. Alain. N. Netherlands.
Netherlands. Shanghai.
Shanghai. I. India.
India. A. Andaman and Nicobar Islands.
Okay, so it was a very good game, right?
Yeah.
So did you like it?
Yes, I like it.
Okay. So anyway, Sachin, tomorrow you call, right?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you for calling. Bye.
Bye.
Okay, so the Sachin who called us, Sachin is a daily caller who calls us, he plays games with us, everything. Okay, so today's topic, I told you I will be telling today's topic after that call. So today's topic is the inventions, a few inventions that changed the world. So there are many inventions now. You know, there's a lot of inventions that are there in this world that we are using. And now, first of all, inventions, there can be a lot of them. So naming a few, maybe a camera, TV, you know, you're watching the TV right now. So that's also an invention. So a camera, TV, you know, even, you know, scissors, it's all invention. Scissors, then the stapler, then you have a lot of things, a stapler, then the barcode, the, you know, first electric bulb, all these are inventions. So now today I will be talking about a few inventions that we use in our daily life. You know, some people maybe use it every day, and in our daily life we use this, and you know, it's very helpful for us. And you know, one fact if you see is that most of the inventions are helpful for us, and some more, you know, maybe out of 100%, maybe you know, at least 45 or 55% inventions are actually to make us, you know, to make us, it's more easy for us. But at the same time, we become more, you know, lazy. So this is one thing, you know, inventions, they make us more lazy and like that. But some are really helpful for us also. You know, there's no other way to do this, but through that, you know, invention, you can do it. So, you know, so today I will be talking about some inventions that change the whole world, that change the, you know, our lifestyle, everything. So the first invention is the most, you know, most important one, that is the wheel. The wheel, everybody has heard of the wheel. We have, you know, there are a lot of types of wheel, but it's not, you know, before it was not the type of wheel we are using right now. The present wheels, the current wheels are actually made of rubber, and it's very, you know, it's compatible for sand, if you're going in the sand, if you're going in slopey areas, and it'll never, you know, it's very good condition, the roads, everywhere you can go. But the olden days, you know, the wheels were actually quite different. It was, you know, you can see a picture, so it was just like this, and you know, now you see bicycle wheels like this. So old time, you know, the bullock carts, the plows, everything, they used to have wheels like this, which was made of wood. So now it's made of rubber and steel inside, like that. But now, you know, before it was made up of wood, just wood. So, you know, I actually, there's a lot of stories about this also I have heard, because, you know, there's a lot of stories that really happened. It's, you know, there was a king who told he doesn't want any circle, you know, wheels, anything like that. So they had to replace everything with squares. So at that time he understood the, you know, value of circles. So in that, at that time, this, you know, the bullock carts, everything. So the king was actually traveling. He was going to another kingdom at this time. Even he told wheels also, everything was circle. So everything circle, they have to be squares. So the wheels also became squares, and suddenly, you know, intruders, thieves, to, you know, steal the king's things, like that. So they came and they stole everything, as the car, you know, the bullock cart couldn't go very fast because it's a square. You can understand, it won't move fast at all, but when it's a circle, it will move fast. So that is one, you know, fact. We see this, you know, wheels everywhere, in toy cars, in cars, you know, everywhere you go, we see this wheels. It helps in moving things from one place to another. So this is one very important thing actually. And now if you are asking about the inventor, who invented this, or which, you know, team invented this, actually this is anonymous. Nobody knows who discovered, invented it, or when it was invented, anything like that. None of us actually know how the wheel was actually discovered. And wheels have made it much easier for us to travel. That is a very huge thing. It is much easier for us to travel, because even if you are going in a plane, you might say a plane doesn't need you know, wheels. But a plane does need wheels, because when you a helicopter can, it can just, it can go from any surface. But if you're talking about an aeroplane, it has to first you know, get that exerting pressure, then only it can fly up. So that's why first it has to roll on the land, and this time it needs wheels. So at this time it has to roll on the land, then only it takes off. So this, you know, even planes need wheels. Every you know, moving vehicle has wheels. So this is one invention that changed the world. And you know, this invention has been, you know, it can be, there was many problems related to, I told you, the kings also. Just like that, at this time there was a revolt also in the manufacturing, you know, that the factory, the industry. Okay, so let's, you know, the next invention. The next invention is a more, you know, a more thing that we all like. you know, something that we all like using, and it's there everywhere we go. Everywhere we go, you can see this. So this is the camera. The camera is actually a very, very, very famous invention. Now also we are using. But the I told you, if there was no camera, we won't be able to record our still and moving photographs within seconds. That also most memorable one, something that you can't see again. Maybe once in a lifetime opportunity, you're going somewhere, so you have to lock all that memories. You can't eventually everyone will forget, but you have to show everyone those pictures. Like that, even moving video camera was invented later on, but the camera that can take still pictures was invented by Joseph N. Niepce. So he was actually a retired military officer. So he invented this, and you can see this picture of a camera right now, and this is not the camera we are using now. This camera is very the ones we are using right now is very handy. You can just slide it in your pocket, and then it's very tiny. You can keep it in pens, you can keep it in buttons. That's small. They can create very small but very effective cameras because of the lens, pixels, everything. So that is one that is one advantage of cameras. And also and before the cameras were just two boxes. Can you believe it? The previous cameras were just two boxes, and actually one box had lens on it and the other box had a screen on it. That's it. So this was a camera which could, this was a previous camera. But now cameras have gone worldwide. There's 41 megapixel cameras, and there is there's a camera on every phone. Okay, not maybe everyone, most phones. Majority of the phones have cameras on them, and then and there's separate cameras also. If you only want camera and video camera purpose, there's a separate camera which you can just slide it in your pocket. So this is all very handy to us, and we can take it anywhere. You can take pictures when you want, like that. So the first camera what he invented, it was not known as camera, it was known as obscura, obscura. It was known as obscura. And I told you it just had two wooden boxes, and one box had a lens and the other had a screen that is usually green in color, and they used to take pictures like that. And another thing is the pinhole camera. I don't know many of you have ever heard about this. The pinhole camera is very, very easy to make. That is one thing. It's very easy to make. You can check videos. You can check how to make those pinhole cameras. You just need a cardboard cylindrical thing. Maybe you can just get a cardboard roll, something like that, from a kitchen. Kitchen towel rolls. You can get that cardboard roll from that, and easily you can make this pinhole camera. And actually, I have made this thing for my school project. I made this pinhole camera, and it works with the same thing, but in this you can't take pictures. That is one thing. It's you can't take pictures, but you can see you will see that thing the thing you see will be upside down, because it's a real image. It's not it's a real image, but actually maybe you won't understand what I'm saying, but when you get when you are in maybe 6th or 7th, you will understand. There's a real image, there's a lot of virtual image, like that. So the object that you're seeing will be upside down if it has a light on it, like a TV, the tube light, a candle. The candle, if you look at the candle with that screen, with the lights off, it will be upside down. So it's a very nice thing, the pinhole camera. You just have to check about it. You can just check how to make it. Easily you can make. Okay, so that is that is a one invention that changed the world. We all know about this invention also. It's not like it's just for some people. We get to buy it for a very cheap very cheap cost. Maybe the camera's price will be lesser than a mobile phone, but in a mobile phone everything is there. There's a camera, there's everything. So this is actually our invention that changed, one of the inventions that changed the world. Okay, so before I go into the I'll just tell what is our invention. So the invention is actually barcode. We all have heard about barcodes, right? barcodes. Wherever you go, you can see barcodes. You, if you go to the supermarket, you can surely everything that is made for consumption or anything that is for sale will have a barcode on it. And this, I'll explain later. Actually, barcode. There's a specific number on the every barcode, and all the line. Barcodes are just like our fingerprints. You might not understand what I'm saying, because all the fingerprints in this world, our fingerprints on our thumbs, or our fingerprints, is different from everybody in this world. So we all are unique. We all have a different thumbprint. So just like zebras have a separate pattern. Every zebra in this world have a separate pattern. They don't have same patterns, just like our thumbprints also. Just like that, even barcodes, all barcodes are never same. Their lines are different. Maybe one line is extra, or maybe one line is thinner, something like that. That is what differentiates difference. You can find the difference from that. And also, after this only the barcode scanner also came. So anyway, before I tell who invented things like that, let's go for a short rhyme. So now, barcode, I told you what is barcode, things like that, and barcode scanner came. Now if you go to buy anything, they'll just scan easily and they'll give you the price. They'll get the price, the quantity, everything. Okay, so anyway, let's go for a short rhyme now.